Greetings. Thank you, Brother Bahir, for your comment about Isaiah 42. Let's talk about Isaiah 42. It identifies the location of the prophesied prophet in Paran, which is Hejaz, Mecca, and Medina. So why do you think it is not a prophecy about Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, but about Jesus, peace be upon him? I believe you are sincere in your desire to find a true path to Almighty God, brother. First, let's read some of Isaiah 42. I won't read all of it in this video. Perhaps a follow-up or part two to this as time permits. Isaiah 42:1. Here is my servant, whom I uphold, my chosen one in whom I delight. I will put my spirit on him, and he will bring justice to the nations. He will not shout or cry out, or raise his voice in the streets. A bruised reed he will not break, and a smoldering wick he will not snuff out. In faithfulness he will bring forth justice. He will not falter or be discouraged till he establishes justice on earth. In his teaching the islands will put their hope. Regarding Isaiah 42, it is important to respect what the Jewish people believed about the message their prophets gave to them. The Jews have never, ever viewed Isaiah 42 as a prophecy of an Arab prophet, learned or unlearned. Mere mention of Paran or a camel did not, and I mean never, convinced Jews this was a mention of an Arab prophet. And there is no logical basis to assert that this somehow defends and supports the claims of Surah 4:157 or Surah 61:6. The Jews knew the prophets and had years to talk with the prophets while the prophets lived. No one ever thinks about that, do they, my friend? We imagine a prophet appears, shouts a few words, someone hears them, writes them down, and then the prophet is nowhere to be found for further explanation. But it likely did not happen that way. We must also understand the Christian interpretation of Isaiah 42 for several reasons. First, all the original Christians were Jews who knew the message of the prophets. Number one, Jesus or Yeshua came and fulfilled part of the contents of Isaiah 42. We know this because Jesus himself declared he fulfilled it. And here is the first of two ways how we know this, Bahir. After Jesus rose from the dead, he lived with the disciples for 7 weeks, nearly 50 days. And during that time, Jesus taught them all that the scriptures said about Jesus. Here is just one documented example that happened only days after the resurrection. Luke 24:24. Then some of the companions went to the tomb and found it just as the women had described, but him they did not see. They did not notice him standing there by the tomb. Then Jesus said to them, "O foolish ones, how slow are your hearts to believe all that the prophets have spoken?" This is what Jesus would say to Muslims if he were here today. How slow are your hearts to believe all that the prophets have spoken? Was it not necessary for the Christ to suffer these things and then to enter his glory? And beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he explained to them what was written in all the scriptures about himself. So, after the resurrection, Jesus spent time teaching them every mention of himself in the scriptures. And beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he explained to them what was written in all the scriptures about himself. All the prophets, all the scriptures. The disciples knew about every scripture describing and foretelling and prophesying of the Messiah. And I have no doubt they wrote them down as they were inspired to record the details. Luke 24:44, Jesus said to them, "These are the words I spoke to you while I was still with you." That means before he died, because now when he's with them, it's after his resurrection. "Everything must be fulfilled that was written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms." Those are three things that Islam tells you you're supposed to claim you believe. So Jesus also taught them these things while he was alive. But there is one other time Jesus directly, specifically, referenced Isaiah 42. Luke 4:16. "Then Jesus came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up. As was his custom, he entered the synagogue on the Sabbath. And when he stood up to read, the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was handed to him. Unrolling it, he found the place where it was written." Jesus was looking for Isaiah 42. He looked until he found it. Unrolling it, he found the place where it was written. "The Spirit of Yahweh, the Lord, is on me, because he has anointed me to preach good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim deliverance to the captives and recovery of the sight to the blind, to release the oppressed." From Isaiah 42:1, "Behold my servant, whom I uphold, mine elect, in whom my soul delights. I have put my spirit upon him. He shall bring forth judgment to the Gentiles." And Jesus kept on reading all the way through this. I didn't highlight it, but notice, "in whom my soul delights." This is talking about God delighting in his servant. There's a nugget here. I won't cover it in this video. And Jesus kept on reading all the way through this. "I am Yahweh, the Lord. I have called you," meaning the servant or Messiah, "in righteousness. I will also hold you by the hand and watch over you. And I will appoint you as a covenant to the people, as a light to the nations." To open blind eyes, to bring out prisoners from the dungeon and those who dwell in darkness from the prison. To proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. Then he, meaning Jesus, rolled up the scroll, returned it to the attendant, and sat down. The eyes of everyone in the synagogue were fixed on him. And he began by saying, "Today, this scripture is fulfilled in your hearing." Today, right here, right now, this prophecy by Isaiah is fulfilled. All that I have just read, this is now come to pass. So when Muslims, 2,000 years later, try to claim Mohammed fulfills this passage, we know, and we know that we know, Islam's claim is a fraud and a lie. Much of Isaiah 42 was already fulfilled, sealed. And in the New Testament, especially the book of Matthew, we see dozens of passages like this, where it quotes, "And Jesus did thus and so, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by prophet Isaiah, or David, or Zechariah, or others." Matthew 12:18 recites and applies Isaiah 42:1. "Here is my servant whom I have chosen, my beloved in whom my soul delights. I will put my spirit on him and he will proclaim justice to the nations." Matthew 12:19 recites and applies Isaiah 42:2. "He will not cry out or raise his voice, nor make his voice heard in the street." Matthew 12:20 recites and applies Isaiah 42:3. A bruised reed he will not break, and a dimly burning wick he will not extinguish. He will faithfully bring forth justice. Matthew 12:21 recites and applies Isaiah 42:4. And in his name shall the Gentiles trust. So there is no question, brother, that the servant of Yahweh God, mentioned in Isaiah 42, is Messiah. Then in verse 42:5, prophet Isaiah begins to speak for and of Yahweh God. Thus says God, Yahweh, the Lord, who created the heavens and stretched them out, who spread out the earth and its offspring, who gives breath to the people on it, and spirit to those who walk in it. Then Yahweh God returns to speak of his servant, the same servant as 42 verse 1 through 42 verse 4. I am the Lord. I have called you in righteousness. I will also hold you by the hand and watch over you, and I will appoint you as a covenant to the people, as a light to the nations. The Messiah said he brought the new covenant. Messiah said he brought the new covenant, which was established by his own blood on the cross. Mark 14:24, he said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many." Prophet Malachi 3:1 revealed Yahweh God would come as the messenger of the covenant, the new covenant. "Behold, I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me. And the Lord whom you seek shall suddenly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant, whom you delight in. Behold, he shall come, saith the Lord of hosts." This cannot be Mohammed, because Mohammed never established a new covenant. A new religion, yes, but not a covenant. Isaiah 42:7, to open blind eyes, to bring out prisoners from the dungeon and those who dwell in darkness from the prison. We know this is Jesus because Jesus opened blind eyes, which no one in history before or since has done. And it does not matter whether you parrot by Allah's permission. Certainly this cannot be Muhammad because Muhammad never opened a blind eye, whether with Allah's permission or not. Isaiah 42:10, sing to Yahweh, the Lord, a new song. Sing his praise from the end of the earth, you who go down to the sea and all that is in it, you islands and those who dwell on them. This is all praising Yahweh God, not Allah. Let the wilderness and its cities lift up their voices, the settlements where Kedar inhabits. Let the inhabitants of Selah sing aloud. Let them shout for joy from the tops of the mountains. The reference here to the settlements of Kedar is Isaiah calling them to worship Yahweh God, not Allah. He tells them to sing to Yahweh for joy. Let them give glory to Yahweh, the Lord, and declare his praise in the coastlands. This is more people encouraged to give glory to Yahweh God. Yahweh the Lord will go forth like a warrior. He, meaning Yahweh God, will arouse his zeal like a man of war. He, meaning Yahweh God, will utter a shout. Yes, he, Yahweh, will raise a war cry. He, Yahweh, will prevail against his enemies. This is all about Yahweh God, brother, and nothing about a man named Muhammad. And it is blasphemy to take Prophet Isaiah's message about Yahweh God and to twist it and pervert it as support for, or worse, worship of Muhammad. I believe you are sincere in your desire to find a true path to Almighty God, brother. Please sincerely think about this and the sin that Islam commits wrongly giving Mohammed God's glory. Isaiah 42 was fulfilled by Messiah. Messiah declared this himself while he lived. Isaiah 42 was fulfilled and can therefore never, ever be a rationale to follow and obey and submit to Mohammed. You are free to believe Islam's desperate lies, brother. But I have presented the clear and proven truth to you that you may find and follow Yahweh, God. There is no doubt, save whether you want the truth and want to submit to the one true God. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, the Messiah, who fulfilled Isaiah 42. Amen.